believe it. Can't believe it. You will never guess what. Finally found the papples. That is the last time you'll hear me refer to them as papples. That is the last time you'll hear me refer to them as that. I like to be calling them pearples. But I found them. Right. Twice I went all the way into central London to buy these. None of the staff even knew what I was talking about. I just merrily walk into my local one in Uxbridge. There they are, bold as brass, on the shelf, pound each. Can't believe it. Anyway, picked three up because, well, I'm shouting because I've got the windows open again, Uxbridge Road. Nice sunny day. I'd love to show you, but I can't because I don't have a very good camera. I'll show you a few pictures because I want the world to know that it can be sunny and nice in England. Anyway, the papples. Purples! Right, got them. That's my receipt. Look, they're a pound each. They've referred to them as disc loose pear, which is actually an abbreviation of discovery loose pear. Don't know whether they've called them that. They are actually papples. Purples! Right, look! That's a purple. Right, first of all, it feels really like speckledy and rough, a bit like a pear. And obviously, it looks like an apple. The label has got pear written on it, which is annoying because it's a purple. There's this coincidence because my favourite colour is purple. That's why I think it should be called a purple. Obviously, they're not the colour. But yeah, right, let's cut into one and let's see what a purple looks inside. Right, as I cut into it, oh, it's quite tough. Now, I don't actually like pears, but the last time I tried a pear was when I was 5, which was, oh my god, way back in 1989. God, that makes me feel old. So, right, I've cut into the purple. And inside it's got pips like an apple. And it smells. Right, I work in a shop, so I'd say they smell more like a pear than an apple, but they do have a bit of an apple tint. Right, I've always got to cut into apples anyway because I'm really unlucky with food. I won't go into details, but I do buy apples sometimes, but I've just got to cut into one first. I'm going to remove the pips. This is the first taste test on YouTube, people. Let's try. Let's find out together what a purple tastes like. Here we go. Right. I knew there was going to be a 50% chance of either liking or hating the purple. I like apples, I don't like pears. It's like real gritty. You know when you eat a red apple, like a Golden Delicious? That's not a red apple, is it? But it's really gritty. It's got that really... It's not like a green apple. At a pound each, I can tell you right now, but they're overpriced. But, really juicy. But, you can really taste the acidity of the apple. It gives that funny feeling on your teeth. I am regretting buying three because one would have been enough. Now I've got to eat them all. And I'm wondering how good for you purples are. I mean, an apple a day is supposed to keep the doctor away, but I've never read about the pear getting in good press. That's why I think the pear should have more of the name. That's why I like to call it purple, apart from my favourite colour being purple. Right, if you go to Marks and Spencer, and you're feeling like giving the purple a bit of a try, I suggest you do.